You might know Google Trends as a way to see silly things people are searching for, but honestly, it's an SEO goldmine. So in this video, I will share 5 ways you can use Google Trends for SEO. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that empowers millions of WordPress sites with easy-to-use SEO and AI tools. And this channel is all about sharing the right SEO knowledge. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. Before everything, let me just give you a quick walkthrough of how to use Google Trends. I know it is straightforward, but to someone who is not familiar, they may not know where to start. So this is the landing page for Google Trends, and if you want to use the tool, you have to click on Explore. Now, when you search for something in Google Trends, you will see some auto-suggest, but it isn't like the usual auto-suggest from Google. For example, if we search SEO, sometimes you will see something that you do not expect, but what you should be focusing on is the description right below the suggestion. SEO could be a search term, and if you select that and scroll down, you will realize that SEO is a very broad search term and could mean many things. SEO is a popular surname in Korea, so you may see some popular Korean stars being added as part of the trends data, and it is not what we want. What we want is the topic, specifically search engine optimization. And now, if you are a search specialist, you know that this data is what you are looking for, so just be mindful of that. And then right below the search term, you can filter the trends data by the location, time, category, and platform. By default, this should be in the country you are living in. But if you want worldwide data on a search term or topic, you can select worldwide. Then, depending on how far you want the data to go, you can select that. For doing keyword research and ideation, I will usually go for past 30 days to 12 months, depending on the pace of change for your niche or industry. If it is a niche like AI, 5 years may not be appropriate as the data may be skewed. I'll explain what I mean in a while. And then, you can select a specific category your search term belongs to. I will explain how you can use this in a while. This is a very useful tool for SEO. And then, you can not only use Google Trends to do research for your blog, you can also use it for topic research for your YouTube channel if you have one, as well as for image, news, and Google Shopping. Now, when you search for trends data, you will see a graph that tells you the general trend of the search term based on the filters you have selected. They will show you the interest by region, as well as the related topics and queries. So that's a quick walkthrough of Google Trends. Now, let's talk about the things you can do with Google Trends for SEO and content marketing. Now, obviously, Google Trends is not a tool that will generate a whole list of keyword ideas. If you want to learn how to do that, you can check out this video right here. But Google Trends will tell you what keywords are trending in your niche or industry. For example, if we want to know what topics or keywords are trending in the golf niche, you see, as we type golf, if we select the search term, the data will include the Volkswagen Golf compact car, which is not what we want. So we will select the sport. Then we want the worldwide data within the past 12 months and the data from web search. As we scroll to the bottom, we will see the related topics. If any of the topics makes sense to you, you can use it to create a piece of content around it. These are the rising topics, meaning topics that are rising in popularity. It doesn't mean that they are the top trending topics, but if you want the all-time trending topics related to what you have searched for, then instead of rising, you will select top. And here are the most trending topics based on the time frame you have selected. I'm not sure why the Volkswagen compact car is still here, but you know, Google Trends is not perfect. But it can help you find semantic relevance to the topic you are searching for. But they are from a bird's eye view. If you want trending keyword ideas instead, meaning those topics you can write a piece of content, you want to look at the related queries section instead. Here you will see the queries that are rising in popularity over the past year, meaning there is a burst of people searching for these keywords over the past year. And if we switch to top, these are the most trending queries people have searched for over the past year related to the golf sport. But of course, with the golf sport, it is really general. The related queries will most likely have a lot of competition, so you can't exactly find long tail keywords or long keywords people are searching for. So feel free to refine your search to something else. For example, golf swing training. Then let's go down to the queries. We see some unrelated rising queries, but we have golf alignment sticks, golf training sticks, and all these. Change rising to top, and we have several more keyword ideas. Now, another way to do keyword research with Google Trends is to leverage on the categories. For example, instead of a specific keyword here, you want to know all the trending how-tos related to golf. So in the field, I would type how-to. And in the category, I would find golf. And here it is. Now we have how to watch Ryder Cup, how to watch US Open Golf, etc. And sometimes you can't find an exact category. For example, you want to know the trending how-tos in digital marketing? You won't find it here. So you may have to refine the category to something more generic. For example, marketing. And you will see a couple of related categories. The most relevant may be the advertising and marketing, as well as search engine optimization and marketing. You can check out the rising keywords, as well as the top trending keywords. Hope you find this keyword research tricks helpful, and if it does, do help us out by smashing that thumbs up. Anyway, let's check out the next use case. Now, this trick is similar to what we have done in the categories. Instead of the how-to search term, you can change it to maybe review. Select the category you need, in our case it is golf, and you will find products that are rising in popularity, as well as the top trending products for over a year. I think this is how some influencers find trending products to talk about as well. But this time frame is a little too long. Maybe we can refine it to past 7 days. And we have products that are rising in popularity in the past 7 days. Top queries might provide even more products. While Google Trends cannot give you an actual search volume, they can give you a good gauge. This is after many trials comparing real data from our Google Search Console with Google Trends data. So what we found is that whenever you see a graph, but right at the bottom you do not see any data, it means that there are about 200 searches a month for that topic. By the way, it doesn't matter if the graph is trending upwards, downwards, or sideways. As long as there is a graph, it means there is search volume. And each of these data cards here represents 100 searches a month. So if all the data cards are present, it means the search term or the topic you have searched for has more than 500 monthly search volume. But be mindful that you should change the timeline to past 30 days to have a clearer gauge of the monthly search volume. That's what we have figured out. Of course, there are other keyword research tools out there that can help you identify search volume. Do you want to know which are the most accurate keyword research tools? Check this out. We have identified two free ones. I hope they'll be helpful. Now imagine you are deciding between creating a blog or YouTube channel in either the social media marketing or the SEO niche, and you want to know which has more potential. So we can search for social media marketing, select the topic, make sure that the worldwide data is selected. We want to see the data for the past 12 months. And for now, let's do the web search. Then what you want to do next is to click on compare. This time around, we can search for search engine optimization and select the topic. And now you will see that search engine optimization is a more trendy topic than social media marketing. If your focus is on YouTube instead, just switch this to YouTube search and you will get your answer. Finally, do you know Google Trends have this Trending Now feature? It will tell you the daily search trends and you can select the location your business is based. The cool thing is, you can know the search trends for the past 24 hours and you can filter it by the following categories. Now, let's say that you are a finance YouTuber in Singapore. You can use this daily search trends to identify trending topics to grow your channel. Check this out. We can talk about the Google stock, Microsoft's earnings call, Meta share price, the Japanese yen, etc. Another way you can use Google Trends for local business is if you are selling, for example, sunglasses in the United States and you want to know which states are important from the position of local SEO. You can check out the interest by sub-region to discover the states you should put more focus on marketing. I presume these are the states that are close to beaches. So from here, you can create location-specific pages to rank for local searches. If you want to learn more about local SEO, you can check out this or this. The links to these videos are in the description. Anyway, if you found this video helpful, how about smashing that thumbs up if you haven't done so? And if there are any other ways you can use Google Trends that I have not mentioned, feel free to share it with us in the comments. We really appreciate that. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.